Ciao, siamo arrivati alla lezione
21.
21. How is with numbers? How's it going? Better?
Could be better.
Well, you practice a little bit, right?
A little bit.
All right, cool. E tu? Che mi dici? What do you tell me? How's it going with numbers? Come va con I numeri? I'm sure everything is great and therefore you're ready for lezione 21. Now, today we're going to learn, guess what? The third group, verbi del terzo gruppo, ire. So, with this group, we're finished. We have all the three groups. All the regulars. There are irregulars, but we don't really care about that right now. Because, I mean, most verbs are regular, so it doesn't really matter. Alright, so again, this is the present tense of the third group. Now, one verb of the third group, very important verb, is to hear. In Italiano si dice sentire.
Sentire.
Sentire. Okay, here we go. Io sento.
Io sento.
Tu senti.
Tu senti.
Lui, lei, sente.
Lui, lei, sente.
Noi sentiamo.
Noi sentiamo.
Voi sentite.
Voi sentite.
Loro sentono.
Loro sentono.
Okay.
So only this changes.
Let's take a look.
I mean, this is the same as in the second group. No, this is the same as in the second group. So only this changes.
Okay, first group is guardo.
Yes.
Vedo, second group, so it's the same. Guardi, vedi, it's the same. Guarda, it's first group is different. Second group is the same as third. Vede.
Yes.
Then vediamo, guardiamo, it's the same. Vedete.
Parlate.
Parlate, vedete, it's they're both different. So
yes,
this is
so.
Very different. Ite. And then sentono is different from first group, which is guardano. And it's the same as the second group.
Yeah. So, I mean, only this changes from the second
yes.
group. And this are the same as in the second group.
Okay. So, I will show you just the endings now. Okay?
Yeah.
Oh.
We should write them down.
Yeah. You should write them down.
Me too.
Sento, I mean, o, I, e. Iamo, ite, ono. Of course, I need to pronounce this to you because otherwise you will probably read I, E, no, in Italiano. O, I, E. Iamo, ite, ono. Chiaro? Now we'll practice with some verbs of the third group, some of the main verbs, which we use every day. Okay. Altri verbi in ire. Other verbs in ire. Dormire. Dormire is to sleep. Do you want to try? Or you want me to do the first?
I think it's better if you do that.
Okay, I'll do the first. So, io dormo. Tu dormi. Lui, lei, dorme. Noi dormiamo. Voi dormite. Loro dormono. Next, partire. Partire means to leave. Do you know the song by Andrea Bocelli? Con te partirò, con te partirò. Maybe in English you heard it, time to say goodbye. But you probably heard it in Italian. Con te partirò, which means with you I shall leave. Okay?
Future.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's partirò. So we're not doing the future now. But I mean the verb, partire. So when you hear the song now, you know.
Now you know.
Alright. So partire, again, I'll conjugate. And then you're up. Parto, io parto. Tu parti. Lui, lei, parte. Noi partiamo. Voi partite. Loro partono. Ok?
Yes.
Ok? Now, you're up, Marina, and you too. Offrire. Offrire means to offer.
Offro, offri, offre, offriamo, offrite, offrono.
Wow, you catch on fast. Good.
Because it's the same in the second group, it's just the difference is just with voice.
She knows everything.
No, come on.
Alright, okay, next one. Aprire, aprire is to open.
Apro, apri, apri la porta.
Yeah, la porta, the door. Good.
Apra, apriamo, aprite.
Wait. Okay, start over. Apro, apri.
Apre.
Apre, okay.
Apriamo, aprite. Aprono.
Perfetto. Ok. Aprono la porta, the door. Good. So now you can use most verbs.
Yeah,
you know, you can conjugate the present tense of every group. So there's really much you can do now. Okay?
Yeah.
Did you have a question for me?
Yeah, I had a question. I went out and I was trying to talk to a guy in a bar, and then we were speaking, and then he showed this to me. So what does it mean? I was like,
this,
something like this.
This,
I don't know.
This means perfetto, like perfetto, like yes. You know, this is more American, I guess.
Yeah.
But we do this.
This.
Sometimes you even
so
whistle.
This means perfetto.
Perfetto. Perfetto. Mm. Although. There's also another meaning that we give to this. We also use this sign, this gesture, when you want to say, I knew it, like you expect something, you say, you can actually whistle, it's better. Like, yeah, of course, like, I knew it, yes? I knew it, okay? Lo sapevo, I knew it. But in general, yes, you can use this to say perfetto. Perfetto.
Ok, grazie. Perfetto.
Prego. Alright, noi ci vediamo alla prossima lezione, che è la numero 22. Let's see if she practiced numbers.
22.
22. Ciao.